is those Jersey boys.
Wyclef Jerry wonder, we gonna take y'all back to the book of basement. One time
I heard a man say Jesus walks. Me myself, I heard Jesus talk. Cause when I heard his beat, I felt Jesus force. I heard it through the wire that he made it out the coma from a fast car. It was a fast
Jerry
car.
Wanted to bring that old school beat back.
Every day is like the wild, wild west. Some of us are bad boys, some of us are outlaws. Unsolved mystery, the killer getaway.
When you reach the stage where you can work and talk, you can do client work and talk at the same
time. Well, I can't right now.
I know, but we're going to have so much fun when you can.
Good morning.
Good morning, Jacob.
Stop. You need to work.
And
you've been so
distracted. And I'm now half an hour behind.
You've been so distracted all day. You just can't find the staff these days.
No.
Okay, so it's week six.
No way, is it week six? So, we are in the last week of November, and this is our sixth week in the office. This is actually the end of the first month that we've had the new girls in. So we're going to be doing a review of their first month, how they found it, the training that they've done, and see how they found it over the last month. We've also got 1 week left to hit our sales target. We're currently on six, I think, with a few more in the pipeline. So we're doing a big push this week. We're also going to be doing our reviews of all the clients' accounts because we had so many start this month that we're going to do a full review of everyone so we can set KPIs, key performance indicators, for the next month and how we want to carry on with their campaign. So it's going to be a busy week and it should be really exciting. Have you done any weekly review vlogs? We'll do that at the end of this month and you can say how your first month as a trial employee has gone.
So Lucy has been in the office for now 1 month. We have been in the office for now...
1.5 months?
1.5 months? Probably, since we moved in.
Since Lucy has now been here 1 month, we've started doing the really important training, and we've now got her learning her left and right.
Yes, as you can see, we've written L and R on her hands because she just...
Struggles.
£100 a month. Yeah, I think that's the plan. I think that we're going to use it as two completely separate campaigns, try and keep one campaign on LinkedIn and one campaign on Facebook.
In that case, we're going to need a contract for LinkedIn and a contract for Facebook.
Yeah, so you're going to need an X contract and a Y contract.
Are you going to remember to get the limited company name? You're not, are you? He's not going to remember. Can I have a sticky note, please? I've been summoned.
What day?
Today. 1:45.
Jury duty. How's it?
Facebook ads. I need to get more of an actual budget. I said to Jacob that we'd actually set an actual set budget that would double every single quarter.
That's a great idea.
Not just for Facebook, but just for like everything.
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Can you turn the heat on in my room?
Yes.
In a bit, Sam.
Ciao. Are you ready to ride? You don't gotta be no billionaire to get a ticket
up to the moon. We all know somebody up there. Yeah, it should do. I think we need to develop the strategy a little more. It's obviously working, so he needs to be able to put that in a way that he understands so that he can then make use of what we're actually doing. There's no point in generating, you know, leads and leads and leads and leads if you can't do anything with the leads.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get that. I think we also need to get down to the basics of actually making sure that they deal with what the situation is. So they actually make... he needs to realise... to be honest, I would... He needs to have that ultimatum where we say, like, you need to...
Lucy, tell us what we're doing.
So today we are sorting out our wine tasting evening, and I'm looking at businesses we want to invite to our wine tasting evening, and looking at doing a landing page, and also choosing names for our domain.
Yeah, so let's hear.
So Jacob's number one choice is Whitney Cheese and Wine Night.
What a brilliant choice that is. I don't think we even need to look at anymore.
He also likes...
searching for mothers who go to book club, that's who it is, isn't it? No, I'm not saying that's what it is. I'm saying that's what Jacob's target market is with Whitney Cheese and
Wine Night. He also likes Whitney Wine Tasting.
Whitney Wine Tasting?
I like that. Whitney Wine Tasting, I like
that.
Or
Whitney Wine Society. But that kind of makes it sound like a group.
Yeah, I mean, the idea is it's an invite-only wine tasting event for local business leaders.
Or my ones are Network and Nibbles.
I'm going to say that's probably too... Yeah, no.
Avalanche and Alcohol.
Avalanche and Alcohol.
Or Business and Beverages.
Business and Beverages?
I quite like that.
That's pretty cool.
Avalanche's business and beverages.
Does it have to say Avalanche?
Well, no,
we're
I
not
mean,
trying it, because if we put that, we're not promoting ourselves.
On the tickets, when
what,
we
damn
put...
Damn Fine Wine Night?
No. Why not Business and Beverages?
I like Business and Bevs.
Business and Bevs.
Admit that's quite good. I thought that off my own head.
I think it creates the wrong impression.
Oh.
That's what we can refer to it as.
Hi, I'm Sam. Kaylee, nice to meet you.
You're right.
This is where we
run
the marketing company.
Okay, cool.
It's pretty
much set up
in here. Have you only
just come here then?
Yeah, a couple weeks ago.
This is our sixth week.
It's our sixth week.
Nice.
Yeah, it's been fun.
Yeah?
Things moving fast, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good.
This is like...
Cool. So yeah, this room.
Right, so this is a new way of portraying how successful our campaigns are going throughout the day and how we are generating results for our clients. So what this is a daily running lead cannon. As the amount of hours grows for the number of clients that we have, we're obviously going to be sending more and more leads over to them. So Lucy, if you'd like to do the honours of updating our running lead count for the day.
What time is it?
It's currently 25 to 11. We've already hit 8 this morning. I think Lucy's going to update it to something now. 10. So the idea is that we're going to show you exactly how many leads we've generated for clients throughout the day. So 10 by 25 to 11 obviously is very, very good. So we'll update it as the day goes on. There you go.
You need to get my chest.
No, I didn't. As they wave the check, it begin to drive reckless. Hope you have a wreck, but walk away deathless. And when they rush the car with the extinguishers, you gesture to the crowd with your fingers up that you're okay. That you're so saved, that you're so brave, cause you live your life with one foot in your own grave. When you're defying death, that's when you're on stage with a million on a dash and the crowd hoping you crash. So with the devil dead and you prepared for this to be your last, you ran out of gas. You don't gotta be no billionaire to get a ticket up to the moon. We all know somebody up there. You need a helping hand, look, I'm right here to help you so clearly now, yeah. So clearly now, yeah. I hope you so clearly. I'm currently working on our terms and conditions as we're growing and increasing our product base and increasing our team base as well. It's important that we also bolster our terms and conditions. Terms and conditions are something that's often overlooked by startups and smaller companies and SMEs, but are extremely, extremely important. Your contract is one thing, but your terms and conditions, the way your business works, your limitation of liability, your payment details are vital. One thing that I could say, and from our experience, is that payment becomes quite an issue when you're dealing with other SMEs because everyone's got cash flow squeezes. Cash flow squeezes are very common in a lot of businesses. So it's important to have a very, very watertight terms and conditions so you know exactly, so your clients know exactly how your payment system works and when to pay you and when you're not going to take any shit from them. Come follow me. I see two kids in the alley, they ski masks with a shot. One says, you ride shotgun, we hit the liquor store. We get the cash, then we take off in the fast car. Yes, they got the dough, that's when I heard the shots blast. They try to speed it up, but the hearse don't move fast. You don't gotta be no billionaire to get a ticket up to the moon. We all know somebody up there. If you need a helping. So coming towards the end of the working day in terms of client work and as you can see by the time lapse you've just seen, it was a very good day for clients' work, and that's one of the things we try to focus on here, is that no matter what we're doing, we're generating leads, we're developing really lead-focused strategies for our clients, because what a lot of marketing companies do and what a lot of marketing strategies that happen in businesses do is that they focus way too much on the fluffy, nice-looking content and don't focus on what actually makes sales, which is the lead generation. You need to focus on the lead generation and what is actually going to turn into actual business for your client, alongside all of the brand equity and the value building stuff. Good morning and welcome to Friday. It's been an extremely fun week this week. We've had a lot of
progression in terms of our new products that I'm going to be talking about soon. We've also had a lot of leads generated for our clients, which again, as of yesterday's stint, I only showed you the running lead count on board. It is a massive focus of ours here at Avalanche, and the reason why we focus a lot on leads now is because we believe in relationships, we believe in people, in business. We believe that if the more people that you speak to, the more people that you talk to in your business, and the more people that you talk to of your customer base, the more successful you're going to be. The reason is, in terms of the five ways, again, if you remember last week, we talked about leads conversion times, average pound sale times, average number of transactions times your margins. We talked about all those things. That the lead to the top of that is all about your relationships, about people. The more people you speak to, the more relationships you have, the more successful you're going to be, and that's fact, and that's what is it's huge across the board of our stuff at Avalanche. So stay tuned for today. We've got some Prosecco and some champagne happening, I think, because we've got some full-time members starting next week, and I don't think there's anything Domino's today. We can't be doing that every single week, but yeah, enjoy. I probably haven't talked to you very much about what Groves Bardsley is. I often say it, but I probably haven't talked to you much about what it actually is. So Groves Bardsley is a property investment and management company. We manage and control a lot of assets across the UK. In fact, it's around £2 million worth across the UK now, and as of next month, we were taking control of our 20th property. We started that 2 years ago, so it's been a very fast-paced growth and really fun, and we've learned a lot, and it's given me a lot of credible information and credibility to be talking to other lenders, to be talking to banks, to be talking to other investors now because of that, because of this business. And what it has allowed us to do is create a nice rent roll, a nice income that's obviously supporting Lane, Abby, myself, without that much really on hands work. It's not as much work as we've got in here. It does take work in terms of rental, things like that, and managing tenants, but it's not as bad as obviously the Avalanche Enterprise. It's obviously not as leverageable because you've got to buy houses and houses and houses, but it's really great business, and property investing is something I would really, really advise everyone to get into, even at a young age, because you can gain control of property through creative manner, and we'll talk about that down the line, but you know, it's a really great thing to do. So that is Groves Bardsley. We're an asset management, property management company. We invest our own money, invest investors' money, and buy properties for great returns. That's it.
Are you confused? So is that going on the board, or is that going to have to wait until next month?
It's not going to count for, she'll come on in midway through November, but that means that I can't put her on as an October sale.
True.
Which is devastating.
Oh, bless.
But I've got two calls for next week.
But that's all going to be... It's all
Are you going to take them and make a sale, yeah?
No.
Why?
Because I don't know what I'm talking about.
Put pressure on yourself, Lucy.
That's I can, shame. But I'll lose the sale.
I'm quite upset about that. I really wanted her to be an October sale.
Well, you know what? Let's just get
You're
the...
failure.
Let's get the...
You're fired. Take me into a board.
Let's get it averaged out next month.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I still think that...
So they dressed as a what?
As a lamb.
What were you dressed as yesterday? An elephant?
No. Oh my god. That's so insulting. He just called me fat. He just called me fat. No, yes, he did. Oh my god.
You're not a full-time employee until next week, therefore you cannot sue me.
11:27 a.m.
Okay, so what we're doing now is we're going to go and speak to the girls because they're coming on full time next month, and today is the day we're going to tell them that. Oh, they pretty much know already, but we're going to give them some.
It's a nice surprise anyway.
Prosecco and some flowers. They're going to start next Monday. So let's get it.
Boss. You got lunch instead. We did discuss it.
Lane wants some.
I bought my own lunch.
Oh. So we would like to officially offer you both full-time employment.
Thank you.
Starting from the 31st of October. And although you didn't have pretty desks set up, we thought that
so
flowers
cute.
And Prosecco might be a nice way to go for it.
Thanks, guys. That's so sweet. Thank you.
You are welcome.
Oh, that's so cute.
Look at the girls and open one of these.
Yeah, I think the girls need to open them.
Would you like to open them?
No, you have to stand in front of the Avalanche sign and open your signing bonus.
Yeah,
well,
do
it. It'll go everywhere. Okay, are we ready, guys? Seriously, because I'm nervous now. This is the pressure.
Yeah.
Are we ready?
Wait for it.
Oh, please don't break anything.
Hey!
So, have you got more glasses?
I'm now currently booking in 101 hours worth of client work.
Oh, so do you work Saturdays now?
101 hours.
I still did
four
the
hours.
Room, right?
4 hours
so
each.
Yeah.
I spoke to Lauren about that last week.
Hmm?
We'll drink it, shall we, Loza?
I can't.
I'm
gonna hit me in a minute. Fall off the ledge.
You've got to chase the chickens. Oh, do you want to keep these ones as employee ones?